Here in I button and description box below, you will get complete playlist of Laplace transform. And here we are going to solve a problem which is from the topic inverse Laplace transform. Basically, I would like to show you something that is from video number 19. Okay, from video number 19 to video number, yes, that is 30. We are solving various problems on the topic inverse Laplace transform. All these questions are very, very, very important. I would suggest you, I would request you to solve each and every problem, okay, and that too in this sequence only, in this sequence only, so that you will get very good command over this topic, okay, and over this, all these questions, out of all these questions, this question number 27 is most important problem, okay. Other questions are also very important, but this is the most important problem, okay. So let us start with the problem. Welcome to video number 27. And in this video, we are going to solve ninth problem on the topic, that is inverse Laplace transform. This is one of the most important question. Okay. So I would request you to please see this video till end, because you're going to learn a lot from this video. So the question is, prove that inverse Laplace transform of s upon s to the power 4 plus s square plus 1 equals to 2 upon root 3 into sine hyperbole t upon 2 into sine root 3 upon 2 t. Okay, or in other words, the question may ask like, evaluate this part. Okay, that is inverse Laplace transform of s upon s to the power 4 plus s square plus 1. Okay, yeah, let us start. This is my f bar of s. So let f bar of s equals to s upon s to the power 4 plus s square plus 1. Okay, yes. I want to make this as a plus b whole square. Okay, how can I make this as a plus b whole square? Yes, if I add plus s square, then this will become s to the power 4 plus 2 s square plus 1, so that I can rewrite this as s square plus 1 whole square. Okay, so if I add s square, then I need to subtract s square. Okay, yes, so this is going to be s upon s to the power 4 plus 2 s square plus 1 minus s square. Fine, yes, now I can rewrite this as s upon s to the power 2 plus 1 whole square. Okay, this term is s to the power 2 plus 1 whole square minus s square. Okay, yes. Now we can see this is a square minus b square. So we have the formula for a square minus b square, that is a plus b and a minus b. Okay, that is s upon a plus b, that is s square plus s plus 1, then into a minus b, that is s square minus s plus 1. Now you must have the very good idea about how to apply partial fraction. Okay, so using partial fraction technique, we can rewrite this as a s plus b upon this part, that is s square plus s plus 1 plus c s plus d upon this part, that is s to the power 2 plus, sorry, minus s plus 1. Okay, now we will take LCM. So denominator will be s square plus s plus 1 into s square minus s plus 1. Okay, and if we compare that with this part, then the the denominator will get cancelled. Okay, then we are going to simply equate, that is numerator part, that is s equals to this into this plus this into this. Okay, yes, so using partial fraction technique, we have s, okay, in the LHS part we have s, okay, and in the IHS part we have this into this plus this into this, that is as plus b into s square minus s plus 1 plus c s plus d into s square plus s plus 1. Okay, we have cancelled the denominator part. Okay, now we will simply, yes, open this bracket, you will get s equals to a into s, as plus as into s square will become a into s cube. Similarly, a into s minus s will become minus as square. Okay, as into 1 will become as. So opening this bracket, we will get this, that is s equals to as cube minus as square plus as plus bs square minus bs plus b plus cs cube plus cs square plus cs plus ds square plus ds plus d. Okay, after opening this bracket, we are going to get this. Now we will simply equate, okay, the coefficients. Okay, now we will simply try to equate the coefficients. First we will equate the coefficient of s cube. Okay, if you see in the LHS part, okay, the coefficient of sq is what? 0. Okay, so write 0 here. Now we'll compare. Now we'll equate the coefficient of s cube in the RHS part. Okay, here you can see, here it is a. Now again, yes, s cube coefficient is what? C. Okay, no other coefficient of s cube. So we can write 0 equals to a plus c. Okay, this is my first equation, let's say. Now we'll equate on equating the coefficient of s square. Okay, now we are going to equate the coefficient of s square. Again, you can see the coefficient of s square is how much? 0. Okay, in the LHS part. Now we'll see the right hand side. This is minus a plus b plus c. Okay, then plus d. Okay, yes. So the on equating the coefficient of s square, you will have 0 equals to minus a plus b plus c plus d. Okay, now on equating the coefficient of s, here we have 1. Okay, here we have a, here we have minus b, here we have plus c, and here we have plus d. Okay, now on equating the yes coefficient of constant, fine, here we have 0. Okay, yes, plus b, then plus d. Okay, yes. So on equating the coefficient of s cube, s square, s and constant, finally we are having 4 equations. Okay, and we need to find the values of a, b, c, d. So 4 equation, 4 unknowns, we can easily get the values of a, b and c, d. Okay, yes. Now let us see. Here we have a plus c equal to 0. Okay, now come to this, that is a plus c. Okay, if you see a plus c, that is 0. So if a plus c equal to 0, then minus b plus d equals to 1. Okay, if a plus c equal to 0, then minus b plus d equals to how much? 1. So we are having this equation. Okay, again from this, that is b plus d equal to 0. Okay, b plus d equal to 0. Okay, b plus d equal to 0, then we are left with minus a plus c equal to 0. Again, minus a plus c equal to 0. So we are having a plus c equal to 0 and minus a plus c equal to 0. Okay, on equating these two, you will see a will get cancelled, 2 c equal to 0, so a equal to, sorry, c equal to 0. Put c equal to 0, you will get again a equal to 0. So we have c equal to 0 and a equal to 0, fine. Now again equating these two equations, that is minus b plus d equal to 1 and b plus d equals to 0. So b plus d equal to 0 and minus b plus d equals to 1. If you see, bb will get cancelled, 2d equals to 1, so d equals to 1 upon 2. Okay, yes, since b plus d equal to 0 and d value is 1 upon 2, so put d equal to half here, we will get b equals to what? Minus half. Okay, so that b plus d equal to 0, d is plus half and d, b is how much? Minus half. So finally we can say like we are having the values of a, b, c and d. Okay, yes, so we can put the values of a, b, c and d. We have a and c as 0. Okay, so these two terms will be 0. B value is how much? Minus half. And d value is how much? Plus half. Okay, so we can write minus half upon this plus half upon this. Okay, and this is equals to what? This is equals to f bar of s, which is equals to this. So yes, now coming to this part, that is, therefore we can rewrite this as s upon s to the power 4 plus s square plus 1 equals to minus half, that is b upon this plus d. Okay, this is plus half. Okay, this is the value of what? D upon this part, that is s square minus s plus 1. Now we are going to take inverse Laplace transform. Okay, this is minus. Okay, yes, now we are going to take inverse Laplace transform on both the sides. So we have, yes, inverse Laplace transform of f bar of s equals to, yes, we are taking minus half common, minus half inverse Laplace transform 1 upon s square plus s plus 1. Okay, yes, again we have plus half s, we are taking plus half s common, then we are left with inverse Laplace transform of 1 upon s to the power 2 minus s, this is minus, okay, minus s plus 1. Okay, yes, yeah, we can, okay, in the next step what we have done, minus half is as it is, inverse Laplace transform of this part, we can rewrite this as this. Okay, we can rewrite this part as this, that is 1 upon s square plus s plus 1. Okay, s square plus s plus 1, we are simply adding and subtracting 1 upon 4. Okay, why we are doing so? Just to make this as a plus b whole square. Again, we are doing, okay, adding 1 by 4 and subtracting 1 by 4, okay, with this, because we want to make this as a plus b whole square. Sorry, a minus b whole square in this term, a plus b whole square in this term. Okay, yes. Now, minus 1 upon 2 inverse Laplace transform of 1 upon, okay, this can be written as s plus 2, s plus half whole square. And here, 1 minus 1 upon 4 can be written as 3 upon 4. 1 minus 1 upon 4 can be written as 3 upon 4. And we can rewrite 3 upon 4 as root 3 upon 2 whole square. Fine. Now coming to this term, that is plus half inverse Laplace transform of 1 upon this. This is going to be s minus half whole square. And this is again, this is what? Root 3 upon 2 whole square. Fine. Now we can see we have s plus half and this is s minus half. So we are going to apply shifting property. Okay. Before that, we need to see what is shifting property. In the properties of inverse Laplace transform, we have seen this. That is inverse Laplace transform of f bar of s minus a can be written as e to the power at into f of t. Remember, here it is s minus a. Okay. And a is what? A is the coefficient of t, which is from this exponential term. Okay. Exponential part. Okay. So here we have s plus half. It means the value of a is how much? Minus half. And here we have s minus half. That means the value of a is how much? Plus half. Here we have a equals to minus half. And here we have a equals to plus half. So shifting property, we are applying shifting property, that is inverse Laplace transform of f bar of s equals to minus half. This is going to be e to the power minus t upon 2. And then we are left with inverse Laplace transform of s square. Okay, 1 upon s square plus root 3 upon 2 whole square. Similarly, this can be written as plus half. Okay, because of this minus 1 upon 2, we can write this as e to the power t upon 2. Basically, we have applied shifting property. Okay, e to the power t upon 2 into inverse Laplace transform of 1 upon s square plus root 3 upon 2 whole square. Fine. Now we are going to apply a formula, that is inverse Laplace transform of 1 upon s square plus a square. Okay. Yes, in the formula of inverse Laplace transform, we have learned about this formula, that is inverse Laplace transform of 1 upon s square plus a square. And the value is 1 upon a times sine a t. Okay, 1 upon a times sine a t. Okay. And if you see, the value of a is how much? Root 3 upon 2. So this is minus half e to the power minus t upon 2. Okay. This is 1 upon a. A is how much? Root 3 upon 2. A 1 upon root 3 upon 2 into sine a t. And the value of a is how much? Root 3 upon 2. Okay. Yes. So here we can cancel 2. Okay. Now coming to this second term, that is plus half as it is e to the power t upon 2 is as it is again. This is what? Inverse Laplace transform of 1 upon s square plus a square. Okay, and the value of a is how much? Root 3 upon 2. So the formula is 1 upon a, that is 1 upon root 3 upon 2 into sine a t, that is sine root 3 upon 2 t. Fine. Again, we are going to cancel this 2. Okay, yes. So we are left with minus 1 upon root 3 into e to the power minus t upon 2, okay, into sine root 3 upon 2 t. Here plus 1 upon root 3 as it is e to the power t upon 2 as it is into sine root 3 upon 2 t. Okay. Yes. Okay. So we have solved up to this part. Now, okay. Most important part. Okay. We are taking root 3 upon 2. Okay. 1 upon root 3 into sine root 3 upon 2 t common. So here we have 1 upon root 3 into sine root 3 upon 2 t. Okay. Because this is common in both the terms. Okay. This 1 upon root 3 into sine root 3 upon 2 t is common in both the terms. We have two terms, first term and this is second term. So after taking this common, we are left with e to the power t upon 2. Okay. Why I am writing this? Because this is coefficient of this is what? Plus 1. Okay. Coefficient of this part is how much? Plus 1. And coefficient of this part is how much? Negative. Because of this negative, we are writing this in the second term. Okay. So this will be minus e to the power minus t upon 2. Okay. We are writing this in second term. And this is e to the power t upon t. Okay, we are writing this in first term. And we are simply multiplying and dividing 2. Okay. We are simply multiplying and dividing 2. Okay. Yes. So taking this 2 here, that is 2 into 2 upon root 3 into sine root 3 upon 2 t. Okay. And taking this 2, okay, below this, or you can say denominator part of this, that is e to power t upon 2 minus e to power minus t upon 2 upon 2. Basically, we are going to apply this formula, that is e to power t minus e to power minus t, e to power t minus e to power minus t upon 2. And this is what? This is sine hyperbolic t. Okay? And if you see, if you compare this with this, the value of t is how much? T upon 2. Okay? So we can rewrite this as what? Yes, this is 2 upon root 3 into sine root 3 upon 2 t. And we can rewrite this as sine hyperbolic t upon 2. Okay? And this is what? This is what? This is my RHS. Okay? So finally, we have proved this. Okay? We can say like LHS equals to RHS. Hence proved. Thank you.